First, there was the burden of a global economic slowdown. Then there was Ebola. Then came the xenophobic attacks in April 2015. Weeks later, there came the new visa regulations for South Africa.
South Africa has a huge tourism industry, and the ripple effect on that, as well as other productive sectors of the economy, will be huge. Add that to a lingering power crisis in the country, and the economy may just take a huge hit.
And the economy did take a hit, according to Statistics SA. Players in the tourism industry in particular have been counting their losses.
With this new regulation, you find people who got properties, homes, you know, second homes in South Africa, but they're not able to come here. And that's just been one of those sad things that this regulation has brought into our economy.
So like them to stay because that's where they're getting their clients from, they're supporting their businesses.
In the year 2013, we sold an estimate of about 50 million rands from Nigeria alone to South Africa. And during this period, what happened is that that number has reduced by up to 50%, or even below.
The government defended its position for many months amidst intense debate, especially the aspect on the protection of children.
If you are coming abroad, you are coming from a country where we need a visa. Like Nigeria, you have to submit the birth certificate together with the letter of consent. There is no change. The only adjustment which we have is around a parent who's coming from a visa-exempt country where we don't require a visa.
They said they're going to be issuing a strong advisory. And we said, what does it mean? You know, so again, we're going to be sitting down and say, what does strong advisory mean? Again, so that we need to go to client in the market and say, when South Africa says they're going to be issuing strong advisory, they're going to be requiring, if you coming with a child, have either one of the following.
An interministerial committee has now looked at the concerns of many and has seen government shift ground on certain aspects. Industry players celebrate cautiously but hopefully.
We, on the whole, we're very excited. I think there's just a few concerns that we have, and the concerns really has to do with removing some ambiguities in some of the concessions they've made.
These things are split into within 3 months to a year and beyond to a year, because we need to make a lot of processes to make sure that we've got checks and balances, and then we'll implement.
Of interest, especially for frequent travelers from Nigeria, is the likelihood of a 10-year multiple entry visa for business people and academics.
What a 10-year traveling visa would do to a tourist would be that he or she would have South Africa as a country to visit and plan to visit at their convenience.
Some experts have projected as much as a 50% drop off booking number since May this year. Some project a 500,000 drop in visitors, which may result in a loss of more than 10 billion rands in 2015. This will include conferencing and conventioning delegates as well as their accompanying family members. The task ahead for government, as the industry attempts to claw back what has been lost, they say, is to do more to dispel the confusion and ambiguities regarding the revised regulations, as well as the speedy implementation of what has been agreed. Betty Dibia, Channels Television News.